வணக்கம் ஐயா. வாட் இஸ் த கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் ஆன் விச் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி அவர் நெக்ஸ்ட் ஐம்லெஸ் மெடிடேஷன் ஐயா?
வணக்கம் மரியப்பன். See, in this series, the fourth aimless meditation, here the context is this: books are lying outside of us, videos that we see, audios that we listen, discourses that we listen to, all things lie outside of us. They will not be of any help to one. In the sense, one will have to, one lives as one thoughts. One is driven by one's thoughts, one's hurts, one's frustrations, one's happy moments. This is what one is. That is originating from within, including the cosmos. The cosmos itself arises by him, from him, because of him. And all these personal pronouns is originating with the feeling of I. I am feeling. The image making process of I am feeling produces the cosmos along with his feeling. His feeling is the cosmos. His original I feeling that arises as himself and as well as the cosmos. That is why at the outset I said books are lying outside of you, videos are lying outside of you, the orators, the discourses that are given to you, that you are listening to, are all coming from outside of you. They are extraneous to your feelings. They are extraneous to your kind of thoughts that you have been associating with, you have been living as yourself. So, these things that are happening from outside of you, reading of books, listening to the discourses, videos, whatever be it, all these things will not be of any help. So what is the direct help, immediate help that can happen to one? He has to turn within himself. The turning within, returning to the source, going to the origin of the I feeling. The I is constantly in the process of image making. The images of I am feeling, I feelings are constantly produced in one, in every living organism, including an insect. It is driven to go to a corner and search for its food. It is always in search of its food, an insect. The plants are always in search of water and light from the sun. They are all already motive driven. They are motivated towards their food. In the same way, we are loaded with the images of the I am feeling at the very origin of I am feeling. Where it arises, it immediately veils the desires, the motives, everything veils. They cloud us. They opaque our inner eye, the intellectual eye. The moment they originate and they are sitting in within us. That is why these things which lie outside of us can't help us. And we will have to turn within and sharpen our gaze. It is not simply sharpening alone. We will have to be constantly dwelling within and go to the source. If a thought arises, immediately we will have to get behind the thinker of the thought. without a thinker, the thinker is hiding himself, veiling himself behind the thinking and the thought. Whereas the thinking and the thought happens because of the thinker. So, the moment, if one or the other image of the I is prevailing in us, has originated in us, we'll have to immediately drop it or feel that we are clouded, veiled by that ongoing feeling or the image of the I feeling or the thought or the thinking or the thinker. Be it anything, inwardly, we will have to be empty, open. It is not emptiness. When you turn within and empty the content, be it anything, if you look at it, that is how the emptying process takes place, and immediately the thought vanishes along with the thinker, the feeling vanishes along with the feeler, the experience, the remembrance of the experience vanishes along with the experiencer. Similarly, the eye feeling, the image making of the eye feeling also stops, and there will be an empty space, open space, which is not simply space, it is something else, but for which you will have to again and again and again, you will have to do this 5 minutes aimless meditation again and again, quite often as you can. You will have to keep on repeating it. As you listen to this satsang, do this 5 minutes aimless meditation often and often in a day. This will give you enormous strength, power. It will be so sharp that you will be that cleansing of the intellect, cleansing of the consciousness automatically takes place in us. That is very essential for us to get rooted in our essential nature, in our original self. This is what this meditation is. We will meet in our next 5 minutes aimless meditation.
Thank you, Ayya.